Ladies and gentlemen, teams, welcome. Let's say the rest of this day is still in front of us. It was a great day. Thanks to you. Brilliantly done. Everything went smooth. Design, cost, everything is judged. So more or less now, it will be interesting seeing who will be the finalists in the engineering design event. But of course now you are all waiting for, let's say, the most interesting, emotional, and the powerful part of this day, which is the business plan presentation finals. And I would like to welcome, first of all, Robert Bikovic and Barbara Schlögl, who will give you a short feedback generally, and then we'll start with the real finals. So give them a hand, please.
Good evening. Good evening, guys. It was a long and exciting day, so only the finals are left, finals of the business plan presentation. But first of all, I'd like to thank all my business plan presentation judges. You really did a good job. I think we can applaud a bit. It was again very interesting to see you performing on the business plan presentation. Now I would like to hand over to Robert Bierkowicz, who was one of our business plan judges, who gives you a short feedback on the presentations.
Hello all, and heartily welcome from on behalf of the business presentation judges to you. It was a hard day, not only the hot temperatures, but also your efforts that we could see during the presentations. This year we had a new topic within the business presentation. We invented the deep dive topic. 3 weeks ago, all the teams got a new issue, a new task to deliver today. And so far as we can see, some did a little bit better, some had a little hard work to do there. But overall, also looking in the time frame of the last 3 years, we see an increasing performance of you all in the term of business presentations. And I know you're all waiting for the party that will now start on with the top three finalists, but on behalf of my colleagues, I would like to thank Barbara as well for her great job that he did today.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, I think it's time to start with the finals. Let's start with the first team. It has the car number one. It's Delft. And I think they're in the finalists for the third time in a row. Congratulations.
May the best team win.
We all have dreams. I, from the company Dream, have a dream. You, as an investment and manufacturing company, have a dream. Delft stands for Delft Realization of Extremely Advanced Machines. That's a product which I plan to sell to you to invest in. Even in modern times, with crisis, I'll make this turn around and make you some money with a product that is mean and green. I'll start off the presentation with an overview of our market. Who is our market? Secondly, the concepts I derived from this market. A little bit more about the car. How are we going to produce it? How are we going to market it? And lastly, how are we going to make a profitable business out of this? Let's start off with the market. I hope you all know the left guy. Do you know the right guy? It's Jan-Peter Balkenende. It's the Prime Minister from the Netherlands. What you may not know about Jan-Peter Balkenende is that he really loves motorsports. Therefore, he's the ideal amateur weekend racer. That's our target market. What does he like? He likes speed. Secondly, status. Being a real car, race car driver, that's what it's about. And, well, what happens? They have all these nice toys which they can use, but due to the crisis, what happens? They're all for sale, and one by one, they will disappear for him. What does he do? That's where we come in. We have a product for him that's both affordable, easy, and green. That's what we want, because not only economy is changing, but also the environment is changing. We have to deal with that. And lastly, we have a car that has great performance. Well, that's the unique combination we're trying to sell. We have the easy drivability of the go-kart and the availability of the go-kart tracks, combined with the safety and the experience of a real Formula car. Market analysis shows that we plan to sell 1,000 cars a year. This is the test of our first prototype. It's the dream car, real Formula dream car. Agile, lightweight, and above all, it looks very nice. And that's also what the end user would like to have, a car which he can display himself in. Let's talk about how we as Dream engineered a product that meets up with the challenges posed by the wishes of our customer. First of all, affordable. The chassis is made of a carbon fiber monocoque with a vacuum infusion method to keep costs down. Furthermore, we optimized parts to be fairly simple and easy to manufacture, which make it profitable to produce the car. Furthermore, sustainability. We have a small single-cylinder lightweight package running by E85 bioethanol. Lastly, easy to drive. It also comes with the sustainability. We have a very, very light car, which makes it sustainable and easy to handle. You can really feel the car do well in cornering. And we also designed suspension setup accordingly for the driver to be fast quickly, because he is an amateur. Well, let's talk about performance. 3.8 seconds to 100 kilometers an hour, 2 G's during cornering, and 150 kilograms. That's what we're talking about. It's a real mean machine. Let's talk about the other facts that are coming with this car. It's a very small car. You can transport it very easily into a small minivan, and it's so light you can even lift it up with only 4 people. If you have strong ones, only 2. Let's talk about the upgrades. I have a few here displayed. First of all, the wheels. They come with standard aluminum wheels, but you can have them anodized or you have custom carbon fiber wheels. Next to that, for the user that would like to have more power, we have power upgrades for the entire power band, pistons, camshafts. We have it all for the user to choose from. But that's not all. We have a wide range of different things for him to choose from. Steering wheel, custom paint job, you name it. Well, the third thing I mentioned, safety, very, very important in motorsports these days. We analyzed the carbon fiber chassis. That's also the reason why we took a carbon fiber chassis, because of its closed shell. That's really a lot safer than just the thin bodywork. Second to that, we did impact tests with your impact attenuator, and we kept the cockpit opening very large to give the driver the ability to get out of the car quickly in case of an emergency. But where do we want to go? Because we are going to develop. That's what we need to do to, once we have this market, deploy this market, to keep in this market and keep our sales up. By 2010, we want to have 25% less fuel use. By 2011, we want to launch our first electric car. In 2012, we will launch a chassis made of biodegradable materials. And by 2014, half of the car will be recyclable. So that's what we're going. Let's talk about the production of the car. We propose together we will do something in-house and outsource something. In-house we will do the composites work, the CNCing and the bonding process, as well as the assembly. And outsource we will do the more simple work like casting, welding and sheet metal. We analyze the flow of different parts for the production and have a proposal to have a nice and efficient lean factory for you guys. Well, we have to sell it at one point. First we have produced it, now we're going to sell it. How are we going to do that? We're going to advert in race car and engineering magazines, have the potential market have test drives around a track nearby. And thirdly, we're going to give demonstrations in highly populated areas to get as much people to like the car. But that's not all. I talked about the amateur weekend racer, but we have another market, or multiple markets. We have the young talent stuck in between the go-karts and the Formula cars. We propose this, Formula Dream Series. In fact, I spoke to Dr. Ludwig Volrad this morning, and if you plan to join us in this joint venture, we will host the first racing series next year on Formula Student Germany. That's also great because a lot of people are there for potential market. So you can get a lot of revenue out of there. Secondly, this class will attract track owners in green racing, which they are trendy with, and which they can get extra revenue out. Thirdly, education. We have the possibility to sell this car to universities for students to learn, to have hands-on experience in race engineering. That's what we're talking about. Well, we have to sell it at some point. Why not do that online? Because we have all these bright young students, they can get access to internet, so that will be great, but we still want to have models at local dealers for the drivers to really feel the car and accommodate themselves in. We're not just selling the car, we're also selling service packages. So when the car broke down, you can either order the parts online, or what you could do is call a customer service and have race guarantee within 48 hours you will have a new car on track. So the business side, that's what we're here for. The car will cost to produce, analysis showed, around 15,000 euros. And an average upgrade package we will sell for 1,500 euros. We're going to sell the car for just 17,500 euros. That's not much money for such a great engineering product. And the upgrade packages, we have a little bit more profit on there to make them really profitable. Well, 1,000 cars a year, 250 average upgrades a year, will lead to a total revenue of 18.5 million a year, with a marketing budget of $500,000 each year. We propose a joint venture where you will have 80% of the share and we will have 20% of the share. You will do all the production, the management and the investment while we only sell the design and conduct the research and development of the car. So that's the joint venture we propose. And we propose it for only $4 million with a yearly depreciation of $800,000 machines. So where will that put us? You have a break-even point in 3 years, after which the total corporation will have a yearly profit of 3.2 million, and for you guys, 2.6 million a year for a yearly investment of 4 million. So to summarize, current economic times are very hard, but still in these times we have found the target group which we can fit our car in. It's easy to drive, affordable to buy, and of course very sustainable. So I suggest let's launch this product and turn current economy around with a dream car and make our dreams together come through. Thank you very much.
thanks to Delft. Now we welcome the first Italian team in the finals. I'm very happy about that. Let's say hello to the University of Padova.
Andrà, stai lì. Torna lì. Torna lì. It worked before. Here we go. Here we go. It goes. Okay. Can I do it? Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to be here tonight. I'm Paolo Versa, I'm the business manager of RaceUp team from University of Padova, Italy. And here we are to talk about our business investment plan that I think you will find very interesting for your future business. Our strategy is based on something that we talk about every day. Crisis. Our idea is that crisis is not just a threat, but it's an opportunity. An opportunity to decide who's gonna survive. Because, as Charles Darwin said once, it's not the strongest of the species that survive, maybe not the most intelligent, but the one that is most adaptive to change. And in this sense, our logo, our animal, the shark, is maybe not the strongest, not maybe the most intelligent, but it survived. Since we are just a few people here in front of me, I would like to keep all the things inside this talk secret. And this is the reason why I'm giving you a non-disclosure agreement that I hope you to sign, since we are also dealing with some banks, and it's very important to keep all information secret for us. Our strategy is based on 6 pillars: creativity, re-engineering, innovation, savings, involvement, and success. By the way, in the folder you will get, you will find a little brochure that you can use to follow the main steps of this presentation. We want to turn threats into opportunities. But let's go and see first, what do we mean for RaceUp? RaceUp is not simply a car, it's more than a car. It's a car designed on customers' desires that covers a real market gap. It's a high profit investment, it's a low risk business for you, as we will show you later. And it's an innovative marketing concept, and I will show you why. The main way to know how good a product is, is asking to the people who are going to buy it, how do you like it? How would you like this car to be? So we made a survey. We interviewed on track 523 people that are young amateur drivers, fans of the racing world, go-kart challenges, and on-track bikers. And we asked them, how do you like this car? How would you like this car to be? And they gave us some feedback. So they said the price should be quite important. It shouldn't cost too much. We are in the middle of a crisis. They said it should cost between $10,000 and $20,000. They said it should be very easy to use. It should allow progressive use from beginners to experts. It should have easy settings, so it should be quite easy to repair. And trial opportunities are very important, since it's not important to have, for example, a car in a store if you cannot try it, if you cannot feel it. You need to have it on stage, but you need it more on track. So we decided to sell three different kind of cars: the silver, the gold, and the platinum. Of course, the characteristic increased with price. And the car is top performance in its category, it's top safety car. It's a friendly technology, no special skill or equipment to set the car or repair it. And most of all, we base everything on modular customization, which means that we customize on easy things. And this allows us to increase sales, keeping costs down. Let's just give a look to the standard race up Formula car. It's a 600cc Ninja Kawasaki engine, and the fiberglass is made, the bodywork is made of fiberglass, as the old Italian design tradition. I ask you to pay attention to this chart, because this is the reason why this is a profitable investment. As you can see, RaceUp fills a real market gap compared to the analysis of competitors with it. And most of all, we ask two people, why do you buy cars? Why the mass market wants to buy cars? It's not because they love them, it's just because they are cheaper and they are easy to be repaired, easy to be set. You can go to any facility and they will repair it. So our idea is take a car, take a Formula car and make it easy to repair. Give a service assistant in every single town so that people are not scared and they will turn their choice from kart to Formula. Our car is the first mass market Formula car. So, goals and targets. We made a world market research and we found out there are 20,000 potential customers interested in buying a car. But most of all, there are 200,000 potential customers interested in driving a car. Which means that despite we are in a crisis and not all people can afford to buy a car, maybe not all the students in university can afford a car, but maybe they would like to drive it and try it. So we give the opportunity to these people not just to buy it, but also to drive it. And we address to have 300 buyers, real buyers in the world, and 3,500 drivers, so people who rent the car. Let's go to basic. Let's go to the production system. Since we have to cut costs and keep costs down for your interest, we designed the whole supply chain and we saw that there are some core activities we must stay on and there are some other places we can outsource. So we will keep that design in-house, assembly, marketing, promotion and part of the sale through our website. We will leverage on a network of certified suppliers. We audit every single supplier we have and we decide to have an official group of franchising facilities that we certified. We already have a contract with one of this group of facilities all around the world. So these people inside these facilities, the technicians are trained to sell, repair, and tune the cars. In every town, there will be someone ready to repair your Formula car of RaceUp. So this for the first 5 years of, we will leverage on a resource to order, which means that we will order pieces when we get the order. This will allow the PD ratio, so the delivery time will be longer, of course, but we will have less stock, so the cost will be cut down. In the phase two of the first 5 years, hoping that you'll be with us still, we'll make the stock assembly to order, which means that we will buy components in advance and assemble them when we get the order, and the PD ratio, the delivery time, will lower. Thanks to reaching the break-even point within the first year, we will be able to release the new model after 3 years. Let's give a look now to the marketing commercial innovation, which actually constitutes the main part of our deep dive topic and our main ideas. As I said before, we do not want to sell 1,000 cars. It's almost impossible. So we decided to sell 300 cars and then promote them through some renting. So race up experience, go on track, and you will have the car for 10 days ready for you. We will provide you everything, the suit, the gloves, the helmets. You just go and drive. Race Up Day is the same thing, but just for one day. Race Up Speed Academy is a driving school. Since the car allows a progressive use, it's very good to be taught how to drive. With all this income, we will get 1,000 cars sold, which we will not actually sell 1,000 cars. We will sell 3,300 cars, but the rest of the income will be like, will equal 700 cars sold. So to the traditional revenues for car sales, spare parts, we addition revenues for events, car rental, driving academy, training for official facilities technicians, customization, engineering and design services. Since we have a very talented and passionate group of designers, we want to give help to other companies who have some little problems with design. And this is our website. Through our website, we will promote a tribe marketing campaign in which we will promote our car. We do not want to have above-the-line marketing. Since it's too expensive for you, we will keep the tribe marketing, the below-the-line, we will leverage on our community, and we will promote the Race Up Formula Championship, which is a championship just for formula cars of Race Up. We made a strategic analysis on SWOT. We realized that on firm level, there are some strengths we have and weaknesses. On industry level, we have opportunities and threats. It's not real to say that we only have strengths and opportunity in a moment of crisis, but always all we can say about this is that the weaknesses are strong enough, the strengths are strong enough to equal the weaknesses and to permit us to be successful. Talking about the strategic analysis of the five forces of Michael Porter, the only medium high risk is with threat of new entrants. So we leverage on a first mover advantage. We want to enter in the market by the beginning of next year, so that we can lock the market and make people buy our car and try them before they can buy other cars or formula cars that can enter the market. Just a quick view on the financial figures, since there are someone who's going to pay. We ask you to have €2 million for the first year, and the revenues will allow you to have an income, net income already for the first year. The gross income for the first year is on the first, in the second column, you will get the share of 60% of the total income. Just to make the point, the duties for investor are to finance with around €2 million before the end of this year. You will get the 51% of the property of the company, 3 position in the board of director out of 5 members, 60% of the gross income per year for the first 3 years. For the following 2 years, we will set up all the details. We released on PricewaterhouseCoopers for making a balance sheet for the first 5 years, which is in this city that we will give you. You will find a balance sheet, forecasting balance sheet for the next 5 years. So, we hope to see you again by the end of August to have another meeting. If you're interested in our proposal that we think is very, very interesting at the moment, and we want to find to end up with a contract by the end of this year and set up activities for the beginning of next year. I just hope that I convinced you, because I'm convinced myself, as Winston Churchill said, it's very important to convince them, but it's even more important to be convinced yourself. I will just try to show you that it's important to survive in these moments, and we are very adaptive to change, as Charles Darwin said. Just a little worse. We will give you a pre-agreement contract. You can give a look at them and maybe let us know with our business card for future contacts. And Miss Aurora and Katerina will give you a refreshing Black Shark cocktail we provided for you. Hope to have enough for everyone.
Thanks to Padova. Now we welcome Stuttgart, but not University of Stuttgart like the two last years, but we welcome the UCE Stuttgart for the first time on the stage.
Er setzt sich da auf die Ecke. Na. Warum läuft der jetzt muss laufen. Okay. Möp, möp. Okay. Good evening, everybody. My name is Johannes Hinch, and in the next few minutes, I will present to you the business plan of my company, BA Engineering from Stuttgart. Stuttgart, the city, but the other team. Okay, before I go into more detail, I want to familiarize you with the most important facts of our business plan. What am I here for today? Well, we built and tested a race car that we now want to market all over Europe. And to be able to do that, we have a capital requirement of 400,000 euros. This is what I'm asking of you. Now, you may ask yourself, what is in it for me? Well, we offer you a 49% share in our company, a company that we expect to make a profit of 800,000 euros over 2 years. Now, if you do the math here, you see you invest 400,000, you get 50% of 800,000. That's a pretty good profit. And we heard before that profits are only made if you take a risk. And to take away the anxiousness about the risk, I will go into the details of our business plan and hope to convince you and get you pumped up for our business. How am I going to do this? At first, I will talk about the market. Then I will talk about the car, tell you how I'm going to sell the car, and then wrap everything up in the financials. Now, the most important question, who are we targeting? We are targeting someone who is not necessarily found in government buildings, but more probably here today. We are targeting the weekend racer. Well, maybe you are the future weekend racers, but this is whom we're targeting. Maybe they are over there, the old ones. It's a person who likes to spend his weekends on racetracks, likes to work on his car, is enthusiastic about racing, lives for racing. Now, the interesting question is, how many of those people are out there? Well, we asked the German motorsport authority called DMSB how many licenses they gave out for motor racing in Germany. The answer is 12,000. Now, not everybody that has a license is necessarily a weekend racer, and not every weekend racer necessarily has a license. So if you take these effects, they equal each other, we think, and the market is, in Germany, 12,000 people. If you put this on a larger scale for Europe, this makes for a market of 60,000 people in Europe. Now, the next question is, how many cars can you sell in 1 year? We figured every 10 years you might want a new car. So we can sell 6,000 cars in 1 year in the whole market. The whole market is selling 6,000 cars. Who's active in this market? Well, we had rumors that there were other Formula student teams that prepare a business. Obviously, those are in the market. And then we think we will compete with go-karts, which are a substitute to our product. Now, you heard about the market size, you heard about the customer, you heard about the competition. What's missing? The price. It's 27,000 euros for our car. How many cars are we going to sell? We think that in 2 years, we can sell 730 cars, which is equal of a market share of 6%. Now, if you think about it, 6% is not too much. But then if you think on the other side, who is active in the market, many other teams, we think that there will be about 10 teams in establishing a business. This is a pretty ambitious target. Now, if you want to sell something, what's the most important thing? Correct, the product. We believe that our product is maybe the best balanced car in the field. Now, why am I saying this? First of all, our product is innovative. For example, we used a basalt fiber to fabricate our outer shell. Basalt fiber is a material that is almost as stiff as carbon, costs as much as glass fiber, and can be processed just like glass fiber. But not only that, our car is also very well handling. This is not only our drivers telling this, that our car is very well handling. We constructed this whole car around the suspension and the tires. Everything is done to lower the center of gravity. For example, we use a dry oil sump system to fit the engine lower into the car. Now, this is about the technical features. I also hope that you already noticed that our car is very attractive, talking about status and stuff, you know? It may even be a style award winning car. We don't know yet. And the last point is, our car is easy to maintain. Remember I talked about the weekend racer who's our target. Well, have you ever tried to weld a frame made of carbon fiber? This is the advantage of our car. In the most important wear and tear parts, it's made of pretty down-to-earth materials. And also the engine is a Honda engine, which you can buy spare parts for in every Honda shop. So for the weekend racer, it will be easy to maintain this car. Now, next question. How are we going to sell this car? Our sales strategy is based on three different coinciding concepts. The first and most important one is called regular sales. I will introduce you to that. Then we target one additional niche market using the open source idea. The concept is called Sleek 2.0. And then we target a second niche market using the do-it-yourself idea with a concept called Build My Sleek. Our regular sales. Well, we will use the internet as our sales channel, have a website where you can buy the car, where you can find out everything about the car. Now, if you're selling online, what's the most important thing? To generate traffic. This is why we will invest 150,000 euros over the 2 years to generate traffic for our page. How are we going to do this? Well, you could place an ad on the dream car site, or you could go here today, give out flyers, everything to bring traffic to our page. But this is not everything. The page can also be used for socializing from the people that own one or maybe want to own one. What can you do on the page? You can chat, you can talk about everything that has to do with the car, you can compare your lap times that you did, and you can maybe tune the car. Talk about ideas to tune the car. Now, talking about tuning, this brings me to the second sales concept I talked about, the additional market called Sleek 2.0. What's the idea? The idea is to have online design competition. How does this work? Well, we will tender a competition for a part that we think is very apt for tuning. In the case of our car, that would probably be our upright, which right now is, let's say, built to last. So there is a way to improve this part of the car, make it lighter, make your car faster. Now we will give out all the necessary information that you need for this, and then we hope that our customers and the people that may become customers will engage in discussion online, talk about the car, maybe even construct the car if there's people that construct the part if there's people that own a program which you can do this, and then we will let the people decide which is the best idea. This is possible because we gave out the specifications first, so we are sure that the car that this part will fit into our car. Is this feasible? Well, we thought about this. Obviously, you have to be careful not to give out too much information, but I will be happy to answer any questions about that later. Now, what is the benefit of this concept? We will create involvement with the customer. We heard about after sales, you know, selling tuning parts. Well, how cool would it be if you designed that part? If you had a take in designing this part that makes your car faster right now? This is the benefit. And the benefit for us is that with this concept, we think that 75 more people will buy our car. Now about the third additional market that I talked about, which is called Build My Sleek. We will sell Sleek as a kit car. If you don't know what a kit car is, I'm sure everybody has bought at IKEA at one point in time. This is the same thing. You buy your car in a box and then you assemble it. Does this work? We put some thought into this, obviously, and we think that if you sell, for example, the drivetrain in one piece, the frame in one piece, other pieces in one piece, and the customer can assemble the rest, for example, the suspension, if you think about it. Obviously, you have to do some adjustments later, for example, to have a straight track, but it's possible. And is there a market for this? Yes. If you go tomorrow, if you go to OBI and watch how many people is there shopping at home improvement stores, then you know that there's a market for do-it-yourself guys. And also I said that the customer is the weekend racer who likes to work on his car. So if you're working on it anyways, why not build the whole thing? What's the benefit? Again, it's customer involvement. The guy gets involved with his own car, and we think that we may be the only people offering this, so 75 additional sales is maybe a very conservative number here. Okay, this is our sales concept. Lots of marketing. Let's see some numbers. Now, if you look at this, what you see here is we will start selling Sleek in Germany. So we have an early sales peak in Germany. We will start a little bit later in Europe because we have to do translations and stuff. So we have a later sales peak in Europe. Then we have a pretty steady sales curve for Build My Sleek and a sales curve that is peaking very late for Sleek 2.0 because you need to generate a critical mass for this concept to work. What is the beauty about this? The revenue function, which is very steady sloping. You can calculate very well, have a very steady revenue coming in. Now let's add some costs. And you see that we break even after 169 cars. This is because we have very low fixed costs, which I will talk about later. And then if we manage to sell the 730 cars that we think we can sell, we make a profit of 800,000 euros. Now, this is lots of numbers, and I will not go into every number, so don't be scared. But what I want to point out here is the variable production costs. We plan to outsource our production. Why would you do this? Well, obviously, you have low fixed costs. The other guy has high fixed costs, but he can manage because he has a steady demand coming in, which is derived from our steady sales curve. And also, what we can do is benefit from his specialization knowledge. We built our first car, but this is not exactly what you call mass production. I think there's other people better at mass production. And so we can give it to them, and they know what to do. Let's do them. Let's get them to do this. Now, if there's a second big chunk of costs here, which is the personal costs. We will have 10 employees at the end of the second year, which are people that will manage Sleek 2.0, people that will manage Build My Sleek, people that will sell cars, and people that will manage the relationship with our outsourced production companies. And obviously people that will manage everything that you have to manage when you have a business. And the last point I want to point out here is that we have a 3% of revenue kept in for any warranty claims coming in. All in all, this makes for a profit of 1,100 euros a car. Now, what did I want to get across this slide? We think that we thought of pretty much everything, and that our car is not only a sound car, but we can also offer you a sound business. And now I hope to see you all again next year on our first shareholder meeting. Thank you.
Three finalists. I think the presentations were really, really impressive. Now I'd like to ask my judges to go behind the stage and have the final discussion. Thanks.
Okay, thanks. Thanks, Barbara. Thanks to the other Stuttgart. Thanks to Delft. Thanks to Padova. Now we start with the first part of the award ceremony. I would like to welcome Professor Kelly and Roberto Maronde to tell us something about style, because yesterday they have done a lot of work to evaluate about the styling of the trucks, the cars. So basically, where are you? Here they are. Please come up. Please give them a hand. Done a great job.
Maybe we can stay together here on this table.
Okay. So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's nice to be back. This year we had 40 entries and 16 qualified for the events here in Hockenheim. And what we'll do now, we'll go through the six finalists and then we'll have 3, 2, 1 and then the winner.
To give a short overview, what we judged, we have 40% for exterior in the style event, 20% for interior, and I have to say, I think some teams forgot this. You can get 20% for interior. But there's also the theory of design, which means 15%, 10% of color and trim, 5% for team presentation during the event, and 10% for application. I have to say it, for application is the first thing what we're judging. What we saw this year is a big gap in the points compared to last year and to the year before. For example, 2 years ago we had for Hamburg 91%. The best team this year have just 75%. And we really thought about.
Yeah, this is a bit strange here. I don't know why. We don't know why. This year has not been as strong as in previous years. It's been, the cars have really been very conservative. And we've seen a few teams saying, yes, but this is our corporate identity. It's more or less a facelift of the car that they had the year before. Now, we're not looking for creative identity, corporate identity, I mean. We're looking for new ideas. I mean, you guys are all great designers, great engineers, why don't you come up with something new? I'm not interested in seeing progressions from the last year. We want something new. This is an exciting time for you. You can do whatever you want. Just this year, it had been very easy for somebody to win this competition because the overall level was very, very similar. It was a level playing field. There was not really so many outstanding designs there. But we did have three who are not so bad, actually. But to go back to this, the problem about being very conservative, we may have a solution for it. We've been thinking about maybe for the 40 people who applied, or the 40 schools who applied for the style event this year, what they can do is if they send proposals to us, say like three sketches, either to myself or Roberto, we can give you maybe a little bit of a recommendation which one of the three proposals would be more interesting for this event. We won't be giving any advice to you, but if you don't know which one should we go for, the more adventurous design or the more conservative, send us an idea, send us your sketches, and it'll all be confidential. We'll give you a little bit of a hint which one you should go for, and you can base your designs on that. But it would be very sad to see the same things happening again, that everybody comes out with very conservative designs. It's not what this event is all about. It's about excitement, it's about creativity, it's about innovation. So if you could send, if you want, you don't need to, but we're there to help. If, say, by the end of February, if you want to send us some sketch proposals, we'll do our best to try and help you.
Yeah, but we had also. But we had also fun this year. Yeah, don't worry. There was some little things. So I have a new favorite team from this year, and it's I call it sticky tape team, which put something like carbon sticker on the carbon bodywork. For me, it was a little bit too much for style event. I will not say the name of the team.
No, we won't mention it was Eindhoven. But anyway, I also had a very interesting presentation from. No, I won't say who it was. I won't say Switch School. They had a very interesting car, but in the interior, they had a special switch. Now, what does this switch do? You press it. And in the footwell area, there comes a blue light. Now, for a racing car, that's something new. There is also a little something special about this light. You can turn it, you can press it again, and then you get a red light in the footwell area. I take it.
The team is sitting over there.
I take it that's from the people from Hamburg who are applauding. For a racing car, I don't know. I mean, are there any people from Belgium here tonight? Belgium? Yeah, great. Now, in Belgium, there is a terrific racing circuit. It's called Spa-Francorchamps, and it's got one of the most horrendous corners ever. It's a horror, but it's one of the most challenging corners. So you can imagine, you're out there with your new race car, you're coming up to La Source, you're down through the gears, you're heading down to Eau Rouge. It's very, very tricky. Not many people have come out of there. If they've made a mistake, that the car is in one piece. So the adrenaline is going, people are looking over the pit wall at you to see if you're lifting, and you're just about to turn in, and then suddenly you think, well, maybe I should turn the blue light to red in the pit wall area. Ladies and gentlemen, the six finalists this year are.
We're starting first with Barcelona. Next is Wiesbaden. The University of Applied Science, Graz. Technical University, Vienna. Saarbrücken. Oh, it's a big team, huh? And the sixth team is Cologne. So we will not give a big summary now, because every team got a summary and a short review during the event. But if you'd like to know how it comes, which team has how many points, you will get your evaluation paper after this presentation from me, if you want.
Okay, so now we go on to the finalists, the three best. In third place, we have Wiesbaden. Congratulations. Well done. Now, in second place, we had a very, very interesting a presentation. You know, we're both designers, so we know who Gaudi is. We know who Colin Chapman is, but these guys seem to think we didn't know that. Second place, well done, Barcelona. Now, in the first place this year, the car wasn't as well presented as it should have been. There were, it could have been a little bit prettier, a little bit more time spent on the presentation of it. There were too many scratches, but it is the car. It looks different, it looks powerful, it looks exciting. It was one of the few cars that I actually sat inside the vehicle. You feel yourself at home in this vehicle. It's exciting, and well done.
The winner is Vienna.
Congratulations. Come here. Okay, do you like to come forward?
Well, I'm sorry that we had
Thank you very much.
Thanks, and please give the two guys a hand, because I think they did a great job. Thanks for the guy. Thanks for that. Thanks for that. Interesting. Next award, we make it short. I would like to welcome Klaus Böttcher from Bosch Motorsport to announce the winner of the Best Use of Electronics Award. Welcome, Mr. Böttcher.
Thank you very much. Welcome here in Hockenheim, in one of the best known motorsport areas in the world. I'm happy to be here to hand over now our award for the best use of electronics, sponsored by Bosch Engineering. Once again, year by year, it was a great pleasure to be here to see so many new innovations, a lot of new ideas, and to discuss a lot of items with so high motivated young engineers. The jury did a hard job. It was not an easy decision. There were a lot of discussions, but at the end of the day, the decision was fixed, and the winner is Technical University of Graz.
Thanks to you as well. Thank you for supporting this. Thank you for the sponsoring. And thanks to the judges for figuring all these things out. We make it short. We are trying to do this quickly. Next award that is awarded today is the Best Use of Adhesives Award, presented and donated by Henkel. I would like to welcome Rudolf Neumeier, Alfred Kaltenbach, and Patricia Gründmüller from Henkel. Please come up. Thanks to you. Thank you. to you.
We just make it short. That's not difficult, because always, if somebody says, please, Rudolf, come to the stage, I immediately forget all the text I've prepared. So the only thing I can remember very precisely is, we will be here next year again. So put into your diary that we will have this award again. You might ask yourself, what the hell is this super glue guy doing here in a racing award? We had super glue with us because some of you showed up with broken shoes and we could help them. But others had got a problem in their car. And also those we could help. But why are we here? Now, we have been supporting a lot of teams during the year with our adhesives. And we have seen that you are real engineers. The questions you have raised did or have been so sophisticated that we have decided that we have to be part of this event. This event is not just for super glue, this event is for engineering adhesives, a real playground. As you have seen, I've forgotten my text, so I can refer to one of those business presentations. And I like the Darwin part, because Darwin said, not the strongest will always survive, and not the most intelligent. And therefore, I'm very happy. And but they might survive the one who is the best in a certain niche, the most appropriate. And we are very well aware that we don't have the most important product for your business, but maybe the best in this niche. And that's what we intend to do. And when we have seen what you are doing with your cars, what you have done with our adhesives in your cars, we have said this is worth to offer an award for the best use of adhesive. And I'm sweating here a little bit, I'm a little bit nervous. That's exactly how you must have felt while you have been presenting your adhesive applications to us. Now, I thought it was also a very good job sharing, because first of all, I had the pain. I had to pencil down the award and to ask you for your applications. Then the pain was with you. You had to work it out and you had to present it. And then you have got thrown the pain back to us. Why? Because you have been so professional. It was overwhelming what we have seen. And sometimes I thought, I get a lesson. And normally we wanted to give you one award, the first place. But after we have seen the applications, we said, oh no, maybe we should have also for the second and third a little gift. And when we have seen the presentations, we decided there must be more than a simple gift. And therefore, we want to give a little bit to the first three teams. Let's start with the third place in our award. The third place, and the winner of the third place, is the Technical University of Munich. Please. Is there somebody from the Technical University of Munich? We have got a small award for you. Ah, I can see some people. Don't be shy. Why are you in the background there? Please come to the stage. I think it's worth. Your job was great. Hey, only 10 seconds with the lady, not more. So We have got a little trophy. I don't know what you will do with one trophy, but maybe there is a small space, such a niche in your university where you can place it. But we have also here a bottle of sparkling wine. We know it's not allowed here. And one thing I can remember also quite well is when I've been a student, I had quite a lot of time compared to now, where I've got a boss who is very demanding. I had a little bit more time, but I didn't have any money. So what we want to offer to you is we want to invite just 15 people of you to a fancy dinner somewhere around Munich. And our frontline, our team manager from Munich, will go in contact you. And then we want to invite you for a nice evening, a nice dinner somewhere around Munich. Congratulations. Now the second place, and the second place I have to say was a more head-to-head race. And in terms of a race, I would say it was a photo finish. And it was difficult to decide. But the University of Stuttgart has got the second place. Where is a representative of the University of Stuttgart? Congratulations! The lady is yours, she has got the trophy. So, I don't know if you have got friends, but I've got here something where you can make friends with. Just take that bottle and have a nice evening. And this guy here, he is our team manager in Baden-Württemberg, and he also said he wants to offer a fancy, nice evening, a dinner, and also the drinks, as well as for the Munich guys, as well as the drinks for 15 people of your team. And if you ask him, he might also invite the lady here. Third, second, and I've seen in TV, they said always, and the winner is, you might ask yourself, where the hell is that town? Zwickau! Yeah. This is a trophy, and what's about a drink? Oh yeah, we have got a bottle of sparkling wine also for you and your team. And then the first prize is we want to invite you to our technology center in Garching for 2 days. You will get the hotel stay, you will get food, drinks, whatever you need, and food and drinks, but then full stop. Hey guys, I've been a student as well, yeah. And I know where to put the full stop. And we will also have a nice evening event, and this will be a surprise for you. I don't want to tell it, but here, this is something like the bonus sheet, and we will agree on a date which is suitable for all of us. So many, many thanks for having participated and keeping good shape, and we wish you all the best. Have a nice evening.
Okay, thank you.
And tomorrow, just the last sentence. Tomorrow, our people will come to your boxes and they will give a small trophy to everybody who participated to our contest, because we think the work which has been put in has to be honored at least with a little present, and this will be given to you tomorrow during the day. So thanks for listening. And you can't imagine what I'm talking about and how much I'm talking if I can remember my text.
Thank you. Thanks to Henkel, thanks for the support. I think that was really, really good. Really showing the passion of Formula students. We have seen in the last days a lot of cars having been checked by some green guys. They were very busy in trying to get you through the scrutineering. And of course, as last year, we would like, together with the DECRA, by Mr. Berg, to donate an award to a car or to the team that has prepared best for the scrutineering. So please come welcome Mr. Berg, who from the DECRA will award the best prepared car for scrutineering.
So I'm somewhat older and I have my text with me. Hi folks, I heard yesterday that there is a hall of pain, not a hall of fame, a hall of pain outside. Is that true? Okay. But I think that we should agree that all of the pain that some of you suffered was absolutely unavoidable to make the Formula Student Germany as safe as ever possible. So ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I want to congratulate the board, the steering committee and the operative team of the Formula Student Germany for the top job that they served this year again. The success story of Formula Student is going on, and DECRA is proud to be a permanent part of the technical partner since the first event in 2006. And that is similar to the role that DECRA is playing on some other racing events, for example, the Deutsche Tourenwagen Masters DTM. As Europe's largest organization of technical experts, DECRA stands for safety in general. And this is emphasized by our new motto, get the world into safety. You can see it on my backside. And thank you. And for the DECRA Automotive Automobile Company, which is the company where I'm working for, that means vehicle safety in particular. So the role of being involved in the scrutineering process of Formula Student is matching the profile of our company very well. And I want to stress again, to be always well prepared is one of the skills of a successful DECRA engineer. That means when a DECRA engineer meets his customer face to face, he has to decide whether a vehicle meets the legal technical requirements on road safety. And the DECRA engineer must be prepared to make a competent and right decision directly on site. And this is in line with the meaning of our award. The most important criterion for receiving this award is not the safety performance of the car, but the quality of the preparation of the car and its team for the scrutineering process to help us to make the scrutineering right in time. That means only teams who pass the scrutineering event on Wednesday and Thursday, and maybe also today, at the first go had a chance to be the winner of our award. And this year, this was not so easy as last year, and most of the teams had to pass the Hall of Fame or the Hall of Pain once again. But some teams remained and could then be ranked by the scrutineering team using a point system. And for the teams then being on the high score, the scrutineers used some soft facts to finally determine the winner of the DECRA award for the best prepared car for scrutineering. And who is the winner? The winner is a team from a University of Applied Sciences, which is located in the southwest of Germany. And congratulations to the Saar Racing Team, car number 50. So please come to me to the stage. And while you are on your way to come to me to the stage, this prize is connected with some money. That means you will receive 500 euro for your maybe to start again next year for the start prize for the Formula Student Germany in 2010. So congratulations, and you helped us a lot to and we need the good prepared teams to have the entire process of scrutineering riding time to start with the dynamic events tomorrow. Thanks again, and this is what I said, the 500 euros, and this is your team cap, and please take it to your head, and thanks again.
Thank you, Mr. Beck, thanks to the DECRA. We really appreciate that. I don't know, maybe some of it belongs as well to another team. I don't know exactly. There's something from Canada. I think there has been some synergies in there. However, I would like, first of all, before we are coming to the end of the award ceremony, where I think we are all waiting for the question who has been winning the business plan presentation finals. First of all, I would like to ask Steve Fox to show up here on stage and in order to announce the engineering design finalists. Give a hand to Steve, please.
Thank you, Tim. I can tell you that 75 design judges toiled over this all day today. And after working our brains out all day, we went into a very tense meeting, a rather long meeting, and a very spirited debate about who is going to design finals. The overall reaction of the judges is that the quality of the cars is just a little bit down this year, and it made our decisions even that much more difficult. So after a very long, intense meeting, we came up with a very short list of select cars, and they are as follows, in no particular order. Western Australia. TU Munich. the other UAS Graz. The last team on this very short, select, prestigious list is Delft. Thank you very much. We look forward to the House of Pain tomorrow night.
Thanks, Steve. Thanks. Very short list. Well, I think there might be several reasons for that. Anyway, I think we're all looking forward to it. We're all extremely embarrassed to see what is going to be the result. So I would like to re-welcome Barbara and Robert. Please tell us who is third, second, and first in terms of business plan presentation.
Thanks. It was a short discussion, and...
But anyway, a hard and tough competition. All the three top teams were very close together, and so close is our decision.
Yes. So let's start with the third place.
Our old and good friends, well known for top performance, the Technical University of Delft. Come to the second place.
But Robert, we don't have a second place.
Oh.
We have to change something.
We have to change something. The second place will become a temporarily first place because of the tight decision that we have tonight. All the business presentation judges came to the conclusion that today we will have two first places. Congratulations to both teams. Please, Stuttgart and Padova.
The temporary first place goes to Stuttgart, and the real first place goes to Padova, but they are both winners.
To all the judges. Very special thanks to the judges. We really appreciate your work, and not, of course, only to the judges of the business plan presentation as well, of design event and the cost event. And basically now we're done. The day today is over officially. I think not for you really, because now you can prepare for tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll really get ready to rumble. We'll see cars driving. It will be extremely dynamic tomorrow. I wish you a good night, have a good night, and see you tomorrow. Thanks.